It's Andy here with Byte Federal, bringing you more exciting crypto updates. And today I want to answer one of your burning questions we keep getting. What determines the price of Bitcoin? Well, before I can answer that, let's make sure we all understand how Bitcoin works. Bitcoin is a digital currency that exists outside of the control of government or financial institutions. It's basically the Batman of currencies. Instead, it uses something called a blockchain, which is basically a giant ledger to publicly keep track of all the transactions. This prevents anyone from committing fraud. Gotta keep everyone honest, you know, but where exactly does Bitcoin come from? In short, it's mined. Not so much a hi-ho, it's off to work we go kind of sense, but there is quite a lot of work involved. Basically, super smart people use super-powered computers to solve super complex math problems. I don't like math either, but the first one to solve it mines Bitcoin. Voila, a new baby Bitcoin is added to the blockchain. Now, we understand the birds and the bees of Bitcoin, but what makes it valuable? Well, it's valuable for the same reason any other kind of currency is valuable, because we say it is. I know that seems really simple, but we all agree that a US dollar has value, even though without the meaning we attach to it. It's just a piece of paper. And so it's the same we use for a Bitcoin. Many other things factor into the value of Bitcoin too, like supply and demand. Think of it like your holographic Charizard card from when you were a kid. Like, I had one too, it's rare and everyone's talking about it. Because of that, it holds a lot of value. But if Pokemon were to just happen to print a bunch more cards, the card's value would drop. The value of the currency also drops as more and more people mine it, and that's why there are Bitcoin mining rules in place. The rules say that for every 210,000 blocks of Bitcoin mined, the reward for solving the block is halved, and this halving happens about once every 4 years. So when Bitcoin was launched, the reward for solving the block was 50 Bitcoin, a lot. 4 years later, it was 25, then 12.5, and now in 2021, it's 6.25. This system prevents the overmining of Bitcoin, basically so that there are never too many Charizards at recess. I know, a lot to take in, but we also have to look at other factors like institutional adoption and accessibility. Bitcoin won't do you much good if you have nowhere to spend it. But as the currency becomes more and more popular, more vendors agree that it has value. We've recently seen companies like PayPal, Overstock.com, Visa, and Tesla accepting Bitcoin as viable payments at their industries. And accessibility, well, that's where Byte Federal Bitcoin ATMs come in, making it easier than ever for you to get into the world of Bitcoin. As Bitcoin becomes more part of your daily lives, the more value it will increase. So why not find a Byte Federal ATM near yourself and go bank yourself? Anyone want to hear? We'll see you soon.